HaSheker. Alma DeShikra, the world of a lie. Everything here is against the truth of God and against the Torah.
Any person who has gotten to the point where he doesn't weigh seed anymore, not only he doesn't weigh seed on purpose, I'm talking about, that's for, of course. I'm talking about he got to a point where he doesn't weigh seed at night, meaning even accidental. He doesn't weigh seed accidentally, he's always called him tzaddik. That's a real tzaddik. That's where Yosef HaTzaddik got his name. Don't be a fool. Don't be one of those people who's like, oh, only once, I'm only gonna try once. Don't be a fool, because there's no such thing as one time. This is both a spiritual and a physical addiction. Because they think, in their opinion, for the most part, they believe it's healthy. Even though there's proven scientific research that has proven that it's actually the opposite, they still claim the same thing. Just like, for example, some people that still believe that they came from monkeys, they still use research of certain scientists that were proven to be scammed. Now, for all of the women that think that I don't have such a problem, the same initiative, the same evil act, according to the Torah, that seems innocent is also not allowed for women. Person knows that a sin is hurting his relationship, hurting her relationship with Hashem Yitzbarach, hurting their relationship with their spouse, hurting their chances to fight a zivug, hurting their financial situation, hurting their life, hurting their olam haba, hurting their olam hazeh, and he still goes back to it. He's a fool, just like the dog. She's a fool, just like the dog. He comes back to his vomit, she comes back to her vomit. You heard it's not allowed. Yeah, but I like my mini skirt. Okay, so you like a dog. Don't be scared. Don't be upset when they call you a dog in Shamayim. Hey, doggy, come on. Come to Gehinom. Come, let's go. Come. It's called Gehinom because the screams and growls from Gehinom reach from one corner of the world until the end. The screams of pain and agony reach from where it is until the end of the galaxy, until the end of the universe. All of the ones that go to Gehinom was because of the enticement of the Yetzirah. Yetzirah came and he said, do this, this, and this. They followed Hashem Yerachem, Hashem Yerachem. Shiva Shemot Yesh LeGehinom Ve'elu Hem. There are seven names to Gehinom, and these are them. Sheol, Avadon, Be'er Shachat, Bor Shaon, Tita Yaven, Tzalmavet, Ve'eretz Tachtit. Hashem Yitbarach decided to show Moshe Rabbeinu Gan Eden and Gehinom. When Moshe Rabbeinu got to Gehinom, he said, what is this place? He screamed, what is this place? He saw the screaming, he saw the fires, he saw the different types of fires, he saw the punishment. Hashem, what is this? Hashem answered Moshe, this is a place that I made to punish the Reshaim that go against me. Moshe Rabbeinu started shaking hysterically. He didn't know if he's classified as a Rasha. He thought he's going there. He thought he brought me here because I'm the Rasha. He started shaking uncontrollably. Moshe Rabbeinu thought he's a Rasha. We see that the ones that were really tzaddikim were very worried about this place. Rabbi Lazar Kapal, he used to say, the newborn will die, the dead will live again, the living will be judged in order that they know, teach, and become aware that he is God, he is the fashioner, he is the creator, he is the discerner, he is the judge, he is the witness, he is the plaintiff, he will judge. Blessed is he before whom there is no iniquity, no forgetfulness, no favoritism, no acceptance of bribery, for everything is his. Know that everything is according to the reckoning. Your evil inclination not promise you, meaning don't fall for the evil inclination that tells you that the grave will allow you to escape. For against your will you were created, against your will you were born, against your will you live, against your will you will die, and against your will you are destined to give an account before the King who rules over kings. The Holy One, blessed is he.
First, the Torah says, If you're going to listen to me and keep my mitzvot, I will reward you and your children for eternity. It's a verse in the Torah. La'ativ lecha ulevanecha ad olam. How huge is the reward that you hid away for your followers that feared you? Those who listen to everything you said, how huge is the reward that you put away? For when? For the afterlife. In the next world, Yoshvim Tzadikim ve'atrotehem l'rashehem ve'nehenim miziv ashchina. Translation, the righteous people in the next world with a crown, special crown to their head, enjoying the greatness of God. What is this greatness in this world? We can only imagine. But one thing we do know, if it's better than all the pleasure we ever dream about in this world combined of all the people, what can go wrong?